in ethanol biorefineries these days, 70% of the downtime is caused by feeding the material into the facility. They're having a lot of trouble doing that. We're all trying to solve the problem of how do you take biomass, in our case it's corn stover, so you can imagine all the bits and pieces of corn that you don't eat, you know, the stalks, the leaves, the husks. They take that, grind it up, they turn into this grainy, powderous, fibrous material, and they need to feed it into a facility somehow. Right now, whenever they're designing equipment, they always have to put in big doors and latches where somebody can get in there with a stick or even a jackhammer in some cases and knock the material out of there because it jams up. We have this energy source that we're growing. You know, we have hundreds of thousands of tons of this material sitting around, and we're not doing anything with it. It's untapped energy that we're putting a lot of energy in to make the material, and we're not getting anything out of it. So just studying that material and its flowability, its mechanical properties, its rheology, in some cases the tribology, it's really an interesting body of work, actually, and there's not a lot of work that's been done. It's a problem that's been plaguing the biorefinery industry now for many, many years. We need to test these materials under very high compacted stresses. We need to test very high shear stresses. And this lab is actually what allows us to do that. You're working with a very practical material with a very practical application. It's all biofuel related. Everything you're doing is a real applicable system where the numbers we measure in this lab are going to go right out and be used in a real system. That's what I've come to appreciate this lab for more than anything, is the ability to be a true bridge between the raw science and pure application, because, you know, we interact with these powdered materials on a daily basis, whether you know it or not, and it's the people that work in this lab that are growing the understanding day by day.